Do you have 3D assets, plants, or material surfaces that you've acquired through Megascan, and you'd like to use their Megascan Quixel Bridge software to easily and quickly bring those assets over into Blender? Well, I got just the add-on for you. It's the Megascan Bridge Blender add-on, which you can find on the Blender market. This add-on isn't free and it will cost you $20. I will have an affiliate link in the description if you're interested in picking it up. Other than that, let's jump straight into it. Once you've downloaded the add-on from the Blender market, you can either drag the zip into your Blender project and click OK to install it, or you can go to Edit, Preferences, Add-ons, click the button in the top right corner, hit Install from Disk, find your add-on, click Install from Disk, search for it, and see that it's now in your add-ons list. Make sure the box is checked on, and we are now good to begin the process. First, you're going to have to set the file path for the Megascan Bridge add-on, or else you won't see it pop up within your end panel, which would be mBridge. So let's do that. Go to your Quixel Bridge application, go to the top left corner, hit Settings, go to the Library path, hit the folder, go to the Downloaded folder, and copy, Ctrl-C, copy the path, go back to Blender, click the folder icon, go to the top, Ctrl-V, paste the path, and hit Accept. Now you should see the End Panel tab appear. To change the size of the files that are imported, texture size, click Size here and pick the texture sizes you'd like to be imported. This will change in the future, and texture sizes will be accessible straight from the End Panel tabs. Under the Models tab, you can select the imported LODs that you would like to be imported, or you could check this box to make sure all LODs are imported when you import LODs. And under this tab, you can change the preview, scale, and pop-up scale. Now, once you have the add-on installed and the file path set up, it's pretty straightforward. Go to your Quixel Bridge program, go to either your assets, plants, or surfaces that you own, find one that you want to import and use. I'm gonna do this funky looking cube. I like it. So I notice now in Quixel Bridge that I have a problem when I hit download here. If you have that same issue, it seems that this tiny download button works. So just use that. Hopefully that will work for you too. Wait for it to download and you will see almost instantaneously it pops up within the add-on. Now if you want to import LODs, which is the lower quality versions, game ready stuff, you can check this box, but I don't. I just want the original. And I'm going to hit import, and there it is. It's in our project, ready to use, just like that. It's really that simple. Now, if you want to see the material nodes, you can click right here, and you'll be shot straight to the material nodes to play with. As you can see, all material nodes are connected to a principal BSDF shader, which means they are ready to be baked if you want to mess around and edit them, which is perfect. You have your categories up here, so you can see everything that you have installed and downloaded, or you can see the specific categories of those things. These are set by Quixel Bridge and not the add-on. These are the subcategories of those things, if those categories have subcategories. And it's pretty much the same thing across the board. If you want to see the file path of that asset that you have selected, you can click up here, and it'll bring you straight to that file. If for any reason your things didn't load in, you can hit refresh right here and it will refresh the library. Now, the only difference here is the material. When you import the material, it will go straight into your materials list, which we can see right here. But if you check off apply material, click on the object and then hit import, it will apply the material to the object you have selected. It will not create extra materials though. Every time you hit import, it will make sure it has the same naming scheme and it will not create a duplicate. If you want duplicates right now, you can just change the name of this. And then if you hit import again, you will get the original name imported as well. So then you'll have successfully created a duplicate. It's a pretty easy workaround. And if you want to import these and put them into your asset library, you can hit mark as asset. And once you hit import, you will now see that when I go to current file that we see that this is now imported as an asset in our asset library, which you could just unmark here. But if you want it back, let's just click it again, and there it is again. As easy as that. And these are also materials ready to be baked. Additionally, I don't want to miss these. If you go to the shading tab at the top of your screen, you will now be presented in your shading tab end panel more options for materials, decals, atlases, imperfections, and displacements, which you can all find in the same way as you found the other assets, except for displacements, it'll be right here. I assume it's not, doesn't have a big section because it's not a, there's not that many. Once you have some of those installed, you just hit import and you drag in the node, and then you have those files ready to go in your shading tab. There's not much more to it, but it's a good thing to keep in mind because it gives you a lot more options to mess around with your materials, such as here's the displacement. We'll just throw this in here and throw that in there. And now it's just a little different. You can kind of see the crevices happening here. Let me just disconnect this and you'll see it even better. Look at that. Now we have a totally different material, just from a little bit of a change. I want to give a disclaimer to anyone who's interested in getting this Megascan's Bridge asset add-on. Megascan is no longer offering these items for sale right now, currently, or for free purchase to be used with the Quixel Bridge software. So this is only for pre-existing users. In the future, Megascan is hoping to create a new software like Quixel Bridge to be compatible with fab.com, which is where the current Megascan assets reside. And hopefully it will also work with assets that are not just Megascan assets. And this add-on, if it is made similarly, will also support that in the future. But for now, only buy this add-on if you already have Quixel Bridge assets by Megascan that you would like to use and take advantage of easily within Blender. Or you just would like to pre-prepare for the future when Fab might drop a Quixel Bridge equivalent for the Megascan assets that reside on Fab. But if you were going for the latter, I would suggest you just hold off until the developer can be certain that they can transfer this add-on's usability. If you found this helpful, again, you can find this add-on in the description. I have an affiliate link, and I appreciate you watching. Let me know what you think down below. Bye-bye.